OK, I want to move on. Have we been strong enough in our condemnation of the situation in Gaza?
I think as everybody can see that it's an international humanitarian crisis, that what Hamas did was totally wrong. You know, it was brutal, it was horrific. And Israel absolutely has a right to defend itself. But they also need to act within international law and humanitarian law. We've set out our position around making sure that there are safe zones, making sure that humanitarian supplies can get through. We are concerned about the level of risk to civilians in the Palestinian territories. And we've made that position very clear.
There's plenty of people, that don't think that we're utilising our power and our influence on the international stage. We had Jackie Southey from Save the Children on our show yesterday. This is what she told us yesterday.
We really acknowledge the government has supported the calls for the humanitarian truce. We would like them to go further for a complete ceasefire and also unfettered humanitarian access. That includes fuel. And New Zealand has incredible global standing. We need to use that standing and use our influence for a peaceful resolution.
Would you consider calling for a complete ceasefire?
I mean, I, at this point, I don't think that's a realistic prospect. What we have asked for is a pause to hostilities, because I think, you know, we've got to get some time. We've also been very clear on our position around humanitarian supplies. They have to be allowed through. Simply shutting off, you know, humanitarian supplies isn't acceptable.
Sure, although some people would say a pause doesn't, it sounds weak, it doesn't sound very strong from us.
It is aligned with language being used by other international partners around the world. Ultimately, we do work with other partners. Now, we don't always agree. If you look at the five-country partnership that we have in this most recent position, this most recent situation, New Zealand has gone further than the four other countries. Two of them abstained from a resolution, two of them voted against, and we voted in favour of it. There's not one international opinion here, and I do think New Zealand is continuing to pursue an international position that's based on our values as a country.
All right, that's outgoing Prime Minister Chris Hipkins joining us live from the Beehive. Thank you so much.
Thank you.